Why do you need ControlNet for SDXL? Have you ever generated images and experienced that one terrible defect that spoils your entire image? Yes, I'm talking about deformed hands. It happens in SDXL, SD1.5 and even the new Stable Diffusion 3. But I have a solution for you. ControlNet. And now also with SDXL. But ControlNet can do more than generate perfect hands or repair them. Stay tuned for the other features I'll show you in the second half and at the end of the video. Hi, I'm Patrick. With this channel I want to explain technology and AI clearly and correctly. But before we begin, this video is sponsored by FaceMod. With FaceMod you can AI face swap online easy and fast. So you don't need a powerful GPU and no additional software. And it can be used both with images and videos. Just upload your image or video, choose a face to swap from your own media or preset templates and save the result. For easy access you can upload images you want to use for swapping. I'm using a photo of myself and some images I've generated with SDXL. You want to have more muscles? Upload a muscle man image and after the analysis swap the face. Now I'm strong. Select a portrait style from lots of templates, choose a face. Now I'm wearing a suit. Wonka from Anime Styles lets me look very creative. For swapping faces in videos there are numerous templates. Choose a template, a face and swap. The result has even glasses. Of course you can upload your own videos including HD and swap the face. Does this guy really look younger than me? You can swap up to 6 faces at same time. Assign a new face to each face in the video and press swap. Simple, isn't it? If you wanna try FaceMod yourself, the link is in the description. Now let's move on to installing ControlNet. We use Automatic1111, the process is same for Windows, Linux and macOS and it's not very difficult. At first we install or upgrade ControlNet to the latest version. This is required to make sure that your ControlNet extension supports SDXL. We install MikuBuild's SD WebUI ControlNet, all links are in the description below. Copy the URL to the extension's Git repository. In the WebUI we select the extensions tab. In install from URL we paste the extension's URL we have just copied. Press install if you haven't installed ControlNet before, like me. If the ControlNet extension is already available, then press check for updates. You should see latest version and date, at least same or newer than the one in this video. Press apply and restart UI. Congratulations, now your ControlNet supports SDXL, well, except for one important point we have to consider. You require special ControlNet models for SDXL. The ControlNet models for Stable Diffusion 1.5 are not compatible with SDXL. There's no official repository for SDXL ControlNet models. We choose the collection from Ilya's Wheel. In files and versions we find what we require. In this tutorial I'll show you how to use the most important models Openpose, Canny and Depth. Feel free to try other models yourself and download as much as you like or you have space on your drive. I'll download Diffusers XL Canny and Diffusers XL Depth in full version. Choose mid or small if you don't have that much disk space. For OpenPose I download T2i Adapter Diffusers XL OpenPose, T2i Adapter XL OpenPose and Seaboard XL OpenPose. Usually I start with Seaboard XL OpenPose and choose the others if the results do not fit or if I need a faster generation speed. Move all downloaded models into your Stable Diffusion WebUI directory, Models, ControlNet. In order to test our installation and generate suitable images, we need an SDXL checkpoint. I've chosen DreamshaperXL Alpha 2 because the turbo version is not available for commercial usage, but you can use it for private usage or choose any other SDXL checkpoint you like to try. Even SDXL base is okay. Move the checkpoint into your Stable Diffusion Web UI directory, Models, Stable Diffusion. Make sure to select the appropriate SDXL checkpoint. An SD1.5 checkpoint will not work with the SDXL ControlNet models. In the description for DreamshaperXL Alpha 2, there was a hint to DPM++ 2SA, so we select this sampling method. Sampling steps is 30, width and height are 1024, as we use SDXL. For CFG use the suggested 8. We type in a very simple prompt and generate. The result is great in order to show you how to use ControlNet. Although one hand looks quite okay, the other one is deformed, misses a finger. For sure you want to know how to repair this hand, you won't be disappointed. We send the image to the Image-to-Image tab and do our first exercise with ControlNet. There are three independent ControlNet units. We enable unit O and Pixel Perfect is usually a good choice. As you remember, we have downloaded ControlNet models for Canny, Depth and Openpose. We start with Openpose. There are different preprocessors, even one for animals. We need a suitable model. We have downloaded three, but when speed doesn't matter, I usually choose CBoard XL OpenPose. Remember, Stable Diffusion checkpoints and ControlNet checkpoints have to match. So combine SDXL with SDXL and SD1.5 with SD1.5. Otherwise, you will run into trouble. With the control weight, you can choose how much the ControlNet unit will influence the image generation. It's a good idea to try different settings, but avoid very high or very low values. For the control mode, in most cases, balanced is a good choice. Although the preprocessor OpenPose Full does a good job, we choose the improved version DW OpenPose Full. The denoising strength is quite important. As we want to override the deformed hand, we will just start with 0.7. But if your background is getting inconsistent, you might want to lower the value, for example, to 0.5. We don't want to regenerate the whole image, only the hand. So we send it to InPaint. Now we InPaint the deformed hand. Very important, I had to learn the hard way that it is not good enough to only inpaint the deformed part. A perfect hand with all fingers will be wider than the current hand, so you have to grant it more space and inpaint a larger area of the image. Otherwise, the result will be most probably deformed in a similar way. Now it's time to generate. The hand is wider and has all five fingers. Now we have a template for our next exercises with ControlNet and generating images with perfect hands. Do you want to know how directly generate good hands without the need to fix them? Then the next chapters are for you, and if you don't want to miss my next videos about such topics, press the subscribe button. You have already seen how to use ControlNet in the Image-to-Image tab. We can use it in the Text-to-Image tab too. Before I show you how to keep image compositions in newly generated images, we'll have a closer look at OpenPose. We drop our last generated image into ControlNet Unit O. Select DW OpenPose Full and press the small button for generating a preview. A low preview has to be enabled. You see a schematic representation of the pose. By choosing Edit, you could even modify some of the points according to your needs and press Send Pose to ControlNet in order to use it for your next image generation. Model is Cyborg XL Openpose again. For SDXL checkpoints, you can increase the resolution to 1024, but that's not a must. Using the preview again, we see the schematic representation is more or less same. Although there are several preprocessors you might want to try, as a rule of thumb, choose DW OpenPose Full for people and Animal OpenPose for animals. Okay, I nearly made a common mistake. Don't forget to enable the control units or units you want to use for your image generation. Let's generate. Style, background, hair, cloth, all differs, but the pose is still same and both hands are correct. So if you have a template with good hands for the pose you want to generate, this is the way to go. Maybe I should mention that I sometimes take pictures of myself in the required pose in order to have such a template, just in order to give you another option. Before we have a look at my preferred ControlNet model, we select Canny. Preprocessor is Canny, we don't want to invert it. Make sure to choose the right Canny model. After running the preprocessor, you notice that the edges are detected. This can be used to reuse an image composition. The edge detection is influenced by the low and high thresholds. Important: although it is stated somewhere else, the edges between low and high are not kept. Rather, it is the case that edges below the low threshold are discarded and values above the high threshold are always kept. So setting both thresholds to low values will result in a lot of edges being detected. Setting both thresholds to high values will result in only the clearest edges being detected. Keep this in mind when planning the composition of your image. We choose the default settings and generate. The style of the image is very different, but the composition is same and the hands are correct. You can influence the image by changing the prompt. Yes, there is a lot of green now. If you want to have the result a bit more independent from the control net, lower the weight, for example, to 0.5. This result reminds me of an artistic butterfly woman. We continue with my preferred control net model and we choose depth. Only if depth doesn't work for me, I usually select Canny and try to enclose the required edges by using the thresholds. Depth has several preprocessors with different levels of detail. Zoe and Hand Refiner do not work on my machine. We start with Midas. It has lowest details, but sometimes this is exactly what we want. Regarding depth, the brighter the pixels, the closer, and the darker, the farther away. It's a very good way of reusing compositions. Lires++ has most details. Lires is between the ++ version and Midas. Anything is between Midas and Lires. Remember, more detail is not always better. Let's use the original prompt. Style is different, composition is same, hands are good. We do an extreme change. We try to generate a man in an armor. I assume we have to lower the control weight, but first let's try with 1. Not sure if it is really a man, and the silver arms are somehow creative. Nevertheless, the fingers do not look good. So we lower the control weight to 0.5 and we require more detail for the hands. We choose Lires++. The hands are much better now and it might be a man with long hair. Anyhow, the influence of our depth map with long hair is obviously very, very high. By changing the prompt, you can influence both the foreground and the background. We see the volcano, but the foreground is very dark. Why not choosing another SDXL model and check the result? We select the SDXL base model and generate the same settings. Although we didn't use the refiner, the result looks better than the one with the custom model. SDXL requires lots of performance and VRAM. You can use ControlNet in same way with SD1.5 checkpoints and ControlNet models. For higher resolutions, you can simply upscale your results. If you want to know how this works, watch my video about upscale.